I think we are ready to our definition. In order to give, before I give this definition, I will remind you a notion that sometimes students feel uncomfortable with, the notion of absolute value, which is not a difficult notion. Absolute value of a number. What is absolute value of a number? I will look at some examples. What is absolute value of number negative 3? It means that we are not going to consider its sign, negative or positive. We just say that the magnitude of this number is 3. It is 3. And the absolute value of number 3 is also 3. And if you look at the coordinate axis, this is a coordinate axis, it has origin and it has scale 1. This will be 2, this will be 3. This will be negative 1, this will be negative 2, this will be negative 3. The absolute value is the distance between the number and the origin. This distance is 3 units long, and this distance is 3 units long. That's what it tells us. So the absolute value of negative 3 equals the absolute value of 3 equals to 3. So the definition of absolute value can be written like this. Absolute value of number x will be number x itself if x is positive or 0, and negative of number x if x is negative. Let's see how this rule works. If I apply absolute value of negative 3, it will be, which one we should apply? This or this? It is a negative number, so I should say it will be negative x. What is x? Negative 3. Negative of negative 3, which is positive 3. Yes, it works fine. And now we are ready to generalize our experience and to give a good definition to the operation of multiplying vectors by numbers. Definition will be the following. Vector v is equal some number, let's say x, multiplied by vector u, is such a vector that, so when we define u equals some number x multiplied by vector u, how do we know x is a number? There is no arrow above it, yeah? So it's a number, it's a scalar. U is a vector, v is a vector. So let's look at our experience. If x is a number, we make u as much longer as x shows us. So I will say the norm of v, the norm, the length of vector v, will be absolute value of x multiplied by the norm of vector u. Why do we have absolute value? Because x can be negative. Absolute value of negative 1 is 1, yes? The length of this vector does not change. Absolute value of negative 3 is 3, so we make vector a 3 times as long, not negative 3 times as long, 3 times as long. And what about the direction? We have to tell about the length and about the direction. The direction will be, for this multiple of a, will be the same as vector a if this number is positive, like here, or like here. And will be opposite if the number is negative. I will denote it like this briefly. I will say v is parallel to u if x is positive or 0. And v is anti-parallel. That's a smart notation for anti-parallel. Yes, two arrows looking in opposite directions to u if x is negative. That's the whole definition. Why did we include x greater or equal 0 with parallel? It doesn't matter. We could actually not consider the case when x is equal to 0, because when x is equal to 0, vector v becomes 0 vector, and therefore its direction is not determined. We can assign a. That's all about the definition. Let's look at the properties. Let's look at the properties of multiplication of vectors by scalars. And these properties, we had four properties for addition. So I will say property number 5 for linear operations would be, if I multiply 1 by vector a, I will still have the same vector a. Really, the direction doesn't change and the length doesn't change. Property number 6. Property number 6. If I multiply two numbers by the same vector, what happens? So I multiply number alpha by number beta multiplying vector a. It will be the same as if I multiply numbers alpha and beta and multiply them both by vector a. And there is a proof of this property. There is a proof of this property in the textbook. If you have questions about this proof, you can look at this. You can try to prove it on your own. The only trick here is to consider absolute values of alphas and betas in all possible cases when alpha and beta are negative or positive. You see the norms are equal, and to see that the directions of the vectors will be the same as well. Property number 7. Alpha multiplied by a plus b will be alpha a plus alpha b. And property number 8, alpha plus beta multiplied by vector a will be alpha a plus beta a. And these two last properties are called the distributive properties. Distributive properties, they show how to distribute, how to multiply through brackets when we consider multiplication and addition combined. I think we will stop here right now, and then we will have to proceed to consider some examples of applying linear operations of addition and vector multiplication. In conclusion, the only thing I have to tell you that any set of objects, a set of objects called vectors, with operations having the same properties as we discovered for geometric vectors, is called a vector space. And all the other examples of vectors that we are going to consider in this class, not only geometric vectors, we'll always have linear operations defined on these objects, which means what is linear operations? Operations having these 8 properties that we established for geometric vectors.